Welcome back. I told you we shall be speaking about Islamic banking, and in studio with us this wonderful morning is Mr. Tego Wolasa, who is the Retail and Product Development Manager, KCB South Bank. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
On board. Good to see you.
I'm actually very happy to be here.
Yes.
To demystify the topic on Islamic banking.
Demystify the topic.
Yes, sir.
That's such a huge word. It sounds misty. But first of all, what is Islamic banking?
Islamic banking, before I will even define the topic, Islamic banking is one area which is totally misunderstood by both Muslims and also those who are not Muslims.
Yes.
But just to give a very short definition, it's a banking that we know. Because I'm sure you know banking, what banking is.
Yeah, I know what banking is.
You have account in banks. The same banking that we have, but it has been subjected to an additional law, which is the Islamic law of contracts.
Yes.
So Islamic banking is not it's not free from the laws that are governing the other banks in Kenya.
Yes.
The Banking Act and all the other laws that govern banks. In addition to those laws, now it is governed by the Islamic law of now commercial law. For example, if you want to walk into Islamic banking, you can open an account.
Yes.
But in addition to those now, we will ask you, what kind of business do you do?
Yes.
If your business is not in line with the Islamic teachings, then we will tell you you cannot be our customer.
Whoa.
So but it's just the same banking
yes.
with an additional set of law.
Wow. That's all. It's only for Muslims or any other person can come in and...
Islamic banking is for everyone.
It's for everyone.
As a matter of fact, people come and ask us whether it's only for Muslims. That's just like asking, going to Mombasa and asking whether biryani is only for the people from the coast. It's a product.
It's a product.
It's a banking product. It's for everyone. And you don't need to be a Muslim to come and get one.
Wow. Amazing. Now you are the Retail and Product Development Manager, KCB Shal Bank.
Yes.
Yeah? And this is a product that was launched back then.
Last,
and people are asking, Shal. You know, I tried to look for the initial, S-A-H-L. Like, what is Shal? Just explain to the normal Mwananchi. Some of us were asking ourselves, what is Shal Bank?
Sahal is an Arabic word.
Yes.
It simply means easy.
Oh, so it's easy.
Easy banking. They make your life easy.
Easy.
So we give you very, we solve your problems.
Yes.
As a matter of fact, if you look at one of our KCB values, you want to simplify your life.
You want to simplify and my life.
In any the same agenda that KCB has, Sahal Banking also want to make your life easy. That's all. If you look at these Arabic terms, they borrow, the Kiswahili words, I mean, they borrow heavily from Arabic.
Yeah.
I'm sure you've heard the term kusahilisha.
Kusahilisha.
Kufanya sahali.
Oh.
So you make it easy for people.
Wow, amazing. Now, on to the first key issue, first of all.
Yes.
How does this particular kind of banking system work? Just in brief, how does this work? And give us that parallel, you know, comparison to the normal banking. What makes Islamic banking different from, you know, the normal banking that we are used to?
Now, as I said earlier, Islamic banking is just a form of banking which is subject to the Kenyan law or whichever country you're in, if you're in Tanzania, Uganda. But in addition, we are subject to the Islamic law of contracts.
What is the Islamic law of contracts?
Now, this, the same way we have the common the law of contracts in Kenya, we'll have now laws governing. For example, Islamically, we are forbidden to earn interest or usury, as you will call it.
Whoa.
There's some prohibitions which are there.
Yes.
That they could be there in Islamic teachings, but might not apply to the general public. One of them is the one I mentioned right now, the prohibition of interest or usury. Dealing in businesses which are contrary to the Islamic teaching, like let's say running a bar.
Yeah, alcohol, a bar.
Alcohol is prohibited Islamically.
So you can't open a bar with a loan from Saul.
Even as a Muslim,
yes.
For anyone who actually follows the teaching, he will tell you that I'm not comfortable opening a bar because it's not in line with the teachings of my religion.
Yes.
Another thing which is prohibited in Islamic finance is the aspect of uncertainty or deception.
Yeah.
Like hiding some information. I'm sure for those who have been to banks, you've heard them complain that banks are hiding some information under the table.
Yeah.
So it's actually prohibited Islamically.
So Sal banking is... totally open.
You'll be told everything. Every put will be put on the table. You'll be told, this is what we are going into. This is what we will give you. This is how the match you'll pay us.
Yeah.
These are the conditions.
Wow.
If you like the condition, you take it. But if you're not happy about it, then you can move on and look for something different. Mm-hmm. So those are, first of all, those are the general law that are governing Islamic finance. Another law is a prohibition of unfair treatment. For example, I work, and maybe you have a student from KU who is in the School of Business and has an idea. Mm-hmm. So if I want to go into partnership with him, and because I have the upper hand, I have the funds, I want to be unfair in the way I treat him and how we negotiate, then that's clearly prohibited Islamically. Mm-hmm. So there are a number of prohibitions which are there in Islamic contract. For example, another one which is very critical for people who have banks and have taken loan from banks, the aspect of compounding.
Yeah.
You realize someone took a loan, he ran into problems, not able to pay.
Yeah.
So what would happen under the normal capitalism or the normal banking is that bank will continue charging you the normal interest.
Yes.
On top of that, there's a penalty, which is, according to most banks, 3 to 10% over and above what you are being charged. Mm-hmm. And then that is compounded again. We charge you interest on your principal today. Then tomorrow morning, yesterday's principal, we come and add the interest plus the penalty, and then we subject it to another interest and another penalty.
Oh, so bankings are basically looting out of people, I feel that way.
Okay, from the Islamic perspective, that's how it is viewed.
Yes.
So that's why Islamic finance now prohibits that kind of aspect of compounding also. Mm-hmm. If you run into problems, if the problem is genuine,
there's like an accident, for example.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Or maybe your shop burnt down and the bank manager is actually seeing it, it's your neighbor. Mm-hmm. You are not supposed to be charged that penalty. The bank is supposed to give you some reprieve.
Wow.
So those are the general contracts governing.
Yes.
Now when I come to now how the Islamic bank work.
Yeah.
First of all, interest is prohibited.
Yeah.
So what we do, we charge profit.
Wow. Interest is prohibited.
Yes, or usury for that matter.
You charge profit.
Yes.
So when I enter a normal bank that's not an Islamic bank, I take a loan, they charge me an interest at a particular rate, right?
Yes.
But you guys, the Islamic bank, you come down to my level and the profits that I'm making, then you take a percentage of it.
Yes, because we have that arrangement as well. Mm-hmm. But let me just describe some two methods how Islamic finance works.
Mm-hmm.
But before explaining that, let me just go one step backwards to make the viewers understand how it works in Kenya. In Kenya, generally, the law prohibits banks from doing businesses other than the business of lending, receiving deposits and lending.
Yes.
That's the law. Mm-hmm. Section 12A, 12B and 12C of the Banking Act prohibits banks.
Mm-hmm.
So when Islamic banks wants to start in Kenya, unfortunately, you don't have regulation for that, but we go and seek waiver from the government, so from Section 12A, which prohibits banks from doing businesses of export, maybe import, manufacturing, wholesale, retail. We get a waiver from Section 12A.
Mm-hmm.
Then we go to Section 12C, which prohibits banks from holding or trading in land and real estate unless they're using those buildings for their business or as staff quarters.
Yeah.
So once we get the waiver, in essence, it means that we have been given a license to open a shop.
All right.
So when a customer comes to us, let's say you want to buy a motor vehicle.
Yes.
In normal banking, we will lend you the money and use the motor vehicle as a collateral. So we load our interest on the money. What we'll do under Islamic finance, we just do like a showroom.
Yeah.
We buy the vehicle that you want and sell to you at a profit. And we are done.
Whoa. Yes. You know, that's not normal for majority of Kenyans. This is something very new. The product has been there since 2015 for KCB.
Yes.
Do we have other people who are offering the same product in Kenya?
Yes, we have a number of banks in Kenya.
Yeah.
Actually, the first bank rolled out Islamic finance in 2005 in Kenya.
Wow, that's almost 11 years.
Yes, KCB followed in 2006, but the proposition that we had at that time did not reach out well.
Mm-hmm.
But the bank went back and now retraced everything. And now the product was relaunched again with a new brand and new everything last year in May. From last year to date, we actually managed to get close to 15,000 customers in close to 1 year. And then the other thing maybe I would like to say compared to the other banks, KCB has a very wide reach. In Kenya alone, we have 200 branches.
Yes.
I don't think there's any bank which is close to that. And then when you come to Islamic banking, work on the tenets of Islamic law, like yes. I said earlier. Mm-hmm. So if you go into the market, you'll see some bank talking about the maybe priding themselves with being very Sharia compliant.
Mm-hmm.
Other banks will pride themselves with their system.
Yeah.
Others with their customer service. But the beauty of having KCB SAHL
mm-hmm.
is that as compared to the other people we are competing with, we brought all those things together.
Oh, you combine them.
Yes, we have the best Sharia scholars in the country.
Yeah.
Because any Islamic bank must have board of scholars who guide them on what to do and what not to do.
What when you are my soma?
Yes.
The heavyweights now. When you are najua chenye kinafaa happen. Wow, that's amazing. Because majority of Kenyans are worried. They might be worried that now you're being religiously biased, developing products for the Islam. How about the Christian? And I told you the Buddha, the Buddhist, who says, are you guys, do you take this into consideration? Have we run into problems with this in Kenya? People are feeling, no, you can't start segmenting banking into Islamic banking. Now we'll have Christian banking. And later on, we shall be having even traditional African banking. Do you have problems
interesting
with that?
Question.
Mm-hmm.
Now, before answering that question, let me also ask you a question.
Yes.
Suppose you have a shop today.
Uh-huh.
Then today in the morning, someone came and asked for brown bread and you don't have.
Mm-hmm.
Then he walks to your neighbor, gets one and buys. Tomorrow the same customer walks to your shop in the morning and asks you, do you remember to bring the brown bread? You don't have it again. He goes to your neighbor and buys. The third day, actually 10 people walk in asking for the same brown bread and say, our neighbors are selling brown bread, but you don't like their shop.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you bring brown bread for us to buy? What will you do as a businessman?
As a businessman?
Yes.
I will look down and consider the situation, brown bread. Then I'll get the brown bread.
Thank you so much. That's exactly what we do at KCB.
Yes.
KCB is the oldest bank in Kenya.
Yeah.
KCB began in 1896. I'm sure you're aware of that.
I'm very aware of that. I was active and wild, you know, then.
And if you had to assume
yes.
that Kenya was actually born in 1963,
yeah.
if you had to go by the independence,
history, uh-huh.
then you will say KCB is the grandfather of Kenya.
Babu Yao,
actually. Babu.
Yeah.
Because KCB was already almost 70, 80 years old
wow.
when KCB was Kenya was being born.
Mm-hmm.
So KCB is a very old bank.
Yes.
And Kenya as a country is very diverse.
Yeah.
There are people from different culture, religion and everything. That's the face we would like to have as KCB. Yeah. Diverse. We cater for everyone.
Mm-hmm.
In Kenya, we have a substantial percentage of Muslims, depending on now which statistics you are looking at,
yeah.
between 12 to 30%. That's a very huge number. If you go by the 12%, that's around 12 million
yeah.
people.
Mm-hmm.
If you go by the 30%, that's around much higher
yeah,
number.
It's way higher.
So these people, majority of them are actually shunning away from banks because of their beliefs.
Yeah.
So we want to be a bank which caters for everyone.
Wow.
If today, the Catholics came and said, we want a Catholic banking.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, the scriptures actually mention that.
Yes.
I'm 100% sure the bank, not just KCB,
yeah,
any financial institution
will
give
up.
Them. Even in mm-hmm. KU today.
Yes.
If there's a high demand
mm-hmm.
for certain course.
Yeah.
I'm sure the university will sit down and develop a curriculum for that mm-hmm. and roll it out.
And do you know that 11 institutions, higher learning institutions, have been banned and they have been told don't continue with business because you guys are just after money, you follow me? Anyway, that's different from what we're discussing, but I had just know that because I was thinking of a business idea to start a Catholic banking system. You know,
and, we can start that
and
together.
I'm like, we won't charge you interest. What we'll charge you
is profit.
I'll just emulate yours, but tell me, you reach out as SAHL Bank, yes. yeah, and the KCB. Do people know about this? Because personally, I didn't know that there's an Islamic product. Maybe it might be familiar to the Muslims.
Yes.
Yeah, they are like concerned. Okay, I want to follow my teachings, and I go to KCB. They tell me there's SAHL. But to somebody outside there who wanna do business with you, have you guys tried to reach out to them?
We are 1 year old. And we've continued to reach out to the population outside there.
Mm-hmm.
As we speak right now, 20% of the customers, from the statistics that we have, 20% of the customers in Islamic banking are not even Muslims. Mm-hmm. They're non-Muslims. And like I said earlier, Islamic banking is not only for Muslims.
Yes.
If I'm to tell you the proposition and the ethical side of it and everything, I'm sure it would appeal to everyone.
Yeah.
For a Muslim, he would come in because of his belief.
Yeah.
For a non-Muslim, he would come into it because of the from the ethical perspective of it.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a kind of banking. The number of contracts that you work on, which I don't want to go into the jargons right now,
mm-hmm.
but some of the contracts, I spoke earlier about buying and selling motor vehicle.
Yeah, definitely.
I've sold it to you.
Mm-hmm.
The return on a profit. If today central bank or the government came and said, now the base lending rate has gone up.
Yeah.
Let's say from currently it's 14, let's mm-hmm. say to 20, 30%. The one we've given you under Sahel Bank will not change. Because we've already sold you the item,
yeah,
and our profit is sealed.
Wow.
I see. So even for a non-Muslim,
yes.
or someone who wants to borrow and then he runs into a problem, on the conventional banking side, the issue of compounding and everything will really punish him.
Yeah.
You can see someone already has a problem, that's why he's not paying the loan.
Mm-hmm.
And then you come and load him again with additional penalties,
mm-hmm. yeah.
and then you compound them. By the end of the day, he will have paid 10 times what he borrowed.
Too sad.
So that's why, if you look at for both sides, for both the Muslims and non-Muslims,
yes,
I'm sure the product will appeal to everyone.
Wow.
That's why when we try to reach out to people, we don't actually choose. Although the Muslims are the primary target, the lowest hanging fruits for us,
yeah,
but we target everyone. And that's why, like I told you, 20% of the customers we have
mm-hmm.
today in the market are not even Muslims.
They're non-Muslims.
Yes.
Wow, amazing. I think I shall be a customer very soon.
Yeah, very much.
Because I don't want to be charged interest. I want somebody to walk with me through this journey of making money and at least to share profit. I think that's a very interesting way of looking at it.
Thank you. Maybe to add something.
Yes.
When you asked me about Islamic banking, you mentioned something about profit.
Yeah.
I come down to your level and ask you
mm-hmm.
how much you can make. We have a similar contract.
Wow.
It's called Musharaka or partnership. Musharaka, you know, ile ya kushirikiana.
Tunashirikiana.
Yeah, it's called Musharaka. Mm-hmm. It's a contract. You have a running business, a going concern. Maybe your total capital that you have in the business around 2 million.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you want to add some 2 million to boost your business. So we come in as partners, 50% shareholders.
Mm-hmm.
We agree on the profit sharing ratio. So whatever profit you make, we share according to the agreed ratio.
Uh-huh.
Maybe we pump in 50%, but we can negotiate and get 40% of the profit that you make, or even 50%, or even 70%.
Mm-hmm.
And in case of loss or risk, now we share according to our ratio.
Wow, that's a good deal.
So we are just
very
normal and natural partners.
Uh-huh.
The only challenges which are there in the market is mm-hmm. It's been making this practical. At times it's challenging because people don't keep books of account. Someone doesn't have a proper books.
Oh, so people are not like operating businesses professionally.
Yes.
Yes.
So we also urge, maybe if there's any viewer
mm-hmm.
who's in business,
yeah,
we'd like to urge, before they now even come and start dealing with the banks, they keep proper books of account.
Yeah.
But the bank can also look at their business and ask, is it worth going into this partnership?
Yeah.
Because
don't
at the
just
end of the
come
day,
with
business.
The verbal evidence.
Yes.
Mimi niko na biashara. Sindio, na nawambia mina mkingi pesa, but I can't show it on the books.
Yes, yes.
Wow. Thank you very much. You know, time is not on our side, apparently.
Thank
we
you.
Can speak about this the whole day. Trust me. In fact, over coffee, I think we should be bringing coffee on the show. Don't you think so? We need coffee on the show so that we just take coffee as we speak about this. But we really appreciate you coming on board, Mr. Wolasa. That's a very interesting name, by the way. Wolasa. There's a youth who call Samani Salasa. Yeah, so they kind of rhyme, but it's beautiful. Thank you
Thank
for coming
you.
Through. God bless you for that.
Thank you so much.
And that product, I shall be a customer very soon.
I'm counting on you.
All right. Thank you very much. God bless you. You've heard it from the horse's mouth. I don't know why they say the horse's mouth, because they're human beings. So let me refresh this. You've heard it from the human being's mouth. And that is Mr. Wolasa Tego. And he's talking about Islamic banking. Very friendly. They don't charge you interest. They share your profit. And they walk with you down on this journey of making money. They don't leave you. They don't say, okay, we give you the money, you sort yourself. If you mess up, we'll come and charge you compounding. You know, he's explained all those aspects. They just walk with you. And it's very user friendly. So I encourage you today. It's not only for Muslims. You can also pick up the product. And I challenge you also out there. If if you don't want to be charged interest and you want to share the profit with your banker, or with your bank actually, why don't you pick up the sound product from KCB Kenya? Sound product, I think it's very user friendly. So that's been it. Banking, quite a technical term, but very interesting. It's been real. Thank you very much.